Dhaka Secondary School, North Karachi campus, and today you are watching English Literature class of Matric class. And in this week, our hours, August 2nd week, and these slides are prepared by Sarfahan, Dhaka Secondary School language teacher. Okay, students. So here comes our August 2nd week syllabus, and in this week, our chapter, the Voice Caliph lesson, and in this, first of all, we cover characters in the story. What are the characters in the story? And then we cover main points of the story. Okay, students. So here comes the characters of the story. Basically, we have four main characters. And the most and important character of the story is Harun Rashid, who was Abbasi Caliph of his time. Then comes the Qazi of Baghdad. Okay, Chief Justice of Abbasi Caliph. Then rich man, who was a gentle and a well-to-do person and wore a very fine cloth. And the fourth one is beggar, who was very dishonest and clever. And I haven't mentioned here white horse. White is also the part of this story. Okay, now here comes the main points of the story, the wise caliph. So in the first, the writer mentioned the introduction of the caliph Harun Rashid, who was known and respected for his justice and wisdom. And at night, he went to the street of Baghdad in order to gain first-hand knowledge of his time. He was very wise and justice. Okay. And he visited Baghdad at night in order to get the to hear or listen the problems of the people to solve them. Okay. So one day, the Qazi of Baghdad came to Caliph and he said to him that, O leader of the people, I have brought before you a dispute which you could not settle. So he wanted to get it settled with the help of Caliph, because Caliph was very wise and justice, and he was very sure about him that he can easily solve this matter. Then Qazi asked the Caliph what is the matter. Then Qazi told him that these two people who the rich man and the beggar, one fighting over a white horse, and everyone was claiming the ownership of the horse. Okay, both of the person, rich man and beggar, were claiming that the horse belongs to him. But how could it be possible? So that's why this was the dispute, and Qazi was unable to solve this problem. That's why he came to Wise Caliph. Then Caliph called the rich man to come first and tell the story. Then rich man says that he was going to the city gate, and when he was riding on this beautiful horse, so this beggar was going on the road. So he begged him to ride up to the city gate. So, and beggar was lame, so he felt very sorry for him. So he got him to the horse, and when the city gate came, he refused to come down and told him that don't tell anyone that this horse belongs to you. And this was the story the rich man told to the caliph. Then caliph ordered poor man to come and tell him that. First of all, when rich beggar came, he claimed that this horse belongs to him, and he started his story and tell that he was going to the city gate, and when he was going on the road, he found this rich man and he wanted to get the loan of this white beautiful horse. So he also said that everyone in the court was thinking that this beautiful and white horse does not belong to a beggar. Everyone was just thinking about it, but he was conning the people and said that he sold everything in order to purchase this beautiful horse. This was the clever story he made to the wise caliph. So he also said that when the city gate came, he did not come down. The rich man did not come down, and he said him to be off and don't mention to anyone. If he says this to anyone, no one is going to believe over him. Okay, that's why he told that he robbed his white horse. And after that Caliph's observation and experiment, he did what he said. He said that it's not a very big task to deal with, it's not a difficult case, so he can deal it or he can solve this case easily. So first of all, wise Caliph said to the beggar to come and touch the horse. When the beggar come further to the horse and touch it, horse did not feel good. Okay, at the touch of his hand, horse did not feel good and he winced at his touch. Then came the Caliph. Then after his touch, Caliph told rich man to come and touch the horse. When he touched the horse feels pleasure and snorted there. And after that, the Caliph's decision came and he said that this horse belongs to rich man. And after this, he said, give this horse to the its master, means to the poor man, or to the rich man. And after it, the Caliph turned to the beggar and said, you are a liar and wicked man. You tried to rob an honest and respectable citizen. You deserve a severe punishment. And if you take forgiveness from this rich man, he will definitely forgive this beggar. Then the caliph admonished him, scolded him, but the rich man was a good person. He took pity on him and he take out a purse of gold coins and he gave some him, and this act was liked by everyone in the court. Okay, friends, this was the wise Caliph's wisdom. Okay, friends.